Hello guys, today we are going to learn about structure of circuit switching and packet switching, and these are my group members. So why we need to learn about switching? Since the invention of telephone, circuit switching has been the dominant technology for voice communication. But then in 1970, packet switching evolved substantially for digital data communications. So it was designed to provide a more efficient facility than circuit switching for bursty data traffic. What is switching? The controlling or routing of signals in circuits to execute logical or arithmetic operations or to transmit data between specific points in a network. Switching may be performed by electronic, optical or electromechanical devices. Moving further, let's see the types of switching. Majorly there are three types of switching: circuit switching, packet switching and message switching. Circuit switching is further divided into space division and time division. Space division, mainly it is the one in which signal paths are physically divided in space, and time division involves sending of bits in particular time slots. In virtual packet switching is mainly further divided into virtual switching and datagram. In virtual circuit, a pre-planned route is established before any packets are sent. Then all the packets follow the same route, like in ATM. In datagram circuit, each packet is treated independently with no reference packets that have gone before. For example, we have internet. Moving further, will be explained by my friend.
Circuit switching means it is a communication path or a sequence of links between two communicating nodes is determined ahead of the actual communication. Basically, it connects two devices. Circuit switching is present on the physical link of the OSI module. A channel is dedicated to the connection. The data is sent as a bit stream through network. The example of what is circuit switching is telephone networks. Circuit switching is explained in the diagram below. When a phone call is placed, a dedicated connection is established between the caller and the receiver through various exchanges or switches. This dedicated connection remains intact until the call is complete. Even if the caller or the other person do not speak for a while, the connection is not broken. It remains intact for the entire duration of the call. What was the problem of circuit switching that packet switching came into existence? First was, it was designed for voice services only. Next, in packet switching, the resources is dedicated to a particular call. For the data transmission, much of the time the connection is idle. The example is web browsing. In circuit switching, the data rate is fixed, so it was difficult to communicate, while both the ends must operate at the same rate during the entire period of connection. This was a problem. So to overcome this, packet switching came into existence. Next, what is packet switching? A data is sent through a network in short blocks, packets. Network links are dynamically shared by packets, many packets. Each packet uses full link bandwidth. That is, bandwidth is the main parameter in packet switching. In the diagram below, in packet switching, there is a computer at the calling end, while there is another computer at the receiving end. In this, there is a computer at the caller and the receiver, with the receiver. The caller sends a packet to the receiver. These packets belong to the same original message, but travel via different routes and also can arrive at destination in different order than how the source has sent it to them. Next, we will be looking about the difference between the circuit switching and packet switching. In circuit switching, there is a physical path between source and destination, while in packet switching, there is no such physical path. In circuit switching, all the packets use same path. In packet switching, there is a different independent path for the packets to travel. In circuit switching, it reserves the entire bandwidth in advance. In packet switching, it does not have reserved bandwidth. In circuit switching, bandwidth is wasted. In packet switching, there is no wastage of bandwidth. In circuit switching, there is no store and forward transmission. In packet switching, it supports store and forward transmission. Circuit switching is suitable for bulk data transmission. Packet switching is not suitable for bulk data transmission. Circuit switching takes time in establishing a connection, while in packet switching, there is no delay in establishing a connection. In circuit switching, there is no alternate route in case of connection failure. Packet switching has an alternate route when there is a connection failure. In circuit switching, the charge is based on distance and time and not on data. In packet switching, charge is based on data only. Circuit switching is transparent, while packet switching is not transparent. The main difference between the two is the circuit switching has information that arrives in order at the receiving end, while in packet switching, the information arrives out of order to the destination. This was all about the difference between the circuit switching and packet switching. For further reference, you can refer to the sites given in the references. Thank you.